much more adventurous than the effort to grow outwards. And the brave Saint Shivaji meets Tukaram, a simple saint. Tukaram greets him, "Oh dear king, I have heard your glory, you have conquered forts far and wide." In Marathi it said, sounds very sweet, it says, "You've conquered forts far and wide, you're a great king." He says, "I have conquered forts far and wide, which is nothing compared to you have conquered the enemies within me." And that journey is a glorious journey. So Manda, people in the age of Kali, do not want to conquer the enemies within. Who wants to deal with anger? Anger is good. I'm an angry young man, yeah. That's a status, angry young man, yeah. Manda, Sumanda, misguided. Manda Bhagya, misguided because there is unlimited kinds of philosophies, unlimited kinds of paths and ways, and it's so difficult to understand who's authentic and who's not, who's really going to give me what finally I want happiness. Ultimately, all of us are sitting here, everyone in this world lives for one thing, happiness. What is going to get me to that happiness? Unlimited paths. Manda. So Manda, Mata Yor, Manda Bhagya. We are not very fortunate in this age, very unlucky, very unlucky. Somehow everything seems to be, when everything seems to be just right, something goes wrong. When my career is going right, health is not good. When health is good, wife is shouting at me. Wife is good, children are shouting at me. Manda Bhagya, and he said, Upadrutaha, above all, mentally disturbed. That's the symptom of this age, that the mind is so difficult to control because of so many distractions, because of so many inputs, so much mass. And Swamiji was saying very beautifully, today we are not so afraid of the weapons of mass destruction as much as the weapons of mass distraction. The weapons of mass distraction have completely, they seem to be, Facebook seems to be the one thing which will get me more friends, but unfortunately it is the one thing which is making people more lonely, more distant, less able to develop real relationships. We have 1,000 likes on Facebook, but not a friend whom we can actually speak to. When someone actually sits next to us, we have the ability to type out pages and pages of my posts, but I can't sit with my friend and have a 5-minute heart-to-heart talk. Upadrata. And in this situation, now Vyasadeva is sitting there with love for every human being. He's thinking, what should I give them? What should I present? Which will give a solution, which will give a holistic solution, not a one-pointed solution, a holistic. And then he compiles the Mahabharata, a beautiful story. Because everyone likes romance, action, adventure, conspiracy, victory, defeat, envy, jealousy, hate, crime. Let me put it all in one story. But the glorious thing of it is, it's not a tale, it's not a fabric, it's not fiction, it's real. And that's what makes the Mahabharata so amazing, so perfect. Of those who live their lives in the Adi Parva 199.110, he describes what is the purpose of this Mahabharata. He keeps it in summary. So please repeat. We're going to sing some shlokas from the Mahabharata. Vistaram Kuru Vamshasya.
Vistaram Kuru Vamshasya.
I'm going to describe Vistaram. I'm going to describe in great detail Kuru Vamshasya. What is the meaning of Vamsha? Vamsha is not just a genealogy. It is not just a history of kings. It is the heart and mind of which ruler ruled how. It is, Vamsha talks about the heart. What qualities did he pass on? What did he rule with? What was his standard? What was his character? Therefore, what happened to the citizens? How did they follow him? What was his life? The beauty of the Mahabharata is the beauty of Vyasadeva's. He has got a microscope and a telescope. The telescope can see far into the future, visionary, seeing what are the repercussions of this action, and the microscope on each character's heart. What went on in his heart? Why did Gandhari do this? Why did Duryodhana do this? When Krishna met Arjuna, what went on in his heart? And that gives us an insight into each character playing the role, both negative and positive. Little negative, little positive. So that allows us, it gives us a beautiful simulation of, if I lead my life in this way, Where will I go? If I live my life in this way, if this decision I make, oh, this one did exactly like this, what happened to him? Okay, I should not do it. So he's saying, Vistaram Kuru Vamshasya Gandharyam Dharma Shilatam.
Gandharyam Dharma Shilatam.
The women, Gandhari, Draupadi, Kunti, so many more. What was their dharma? What was their shilatam? What was their, how did they live their lives? Some were widows, some were married to 5 husbands, opposites. Some were having 100 sons, some were young, some were old, some left with their husbands. What is the dharma of a woman? Because womanhood is something very sacred, something very pure. And when exploited, entire society suffers. Mm. And what was it? When someone was exploited, what happens? And when they were protected, what happens? Gandhari Dharmashi. Kshato Pranyam.
Kshato Pranyam.
The wisdom, especially of Vidura and wisdom in general. What is wisdom? What knowledge should we call upon in different situations of our life? Dhritim Kuntya.
Dhritim Kuntya.
Samyak Dvaipanayo Braveet. And so Vyasadeva is going to write down. Vasudevasya Mahatmyam.
Vasudevasya Mahatmyam.
Pandavanam cha Satyatam.
Pandavanam cha Satyatam.
Durvrittam Dhartarashtranam.
Durvrittam Dhartarashtranam.
Tavam Bhagavan Rishihi.
Tavam Bhagavan Rishihi.
Vasudevasya Mahatmyam. Who was Krishna? What role did he play? Was he an ordinary person, extraordinary person, superhuman, or God himself? Why did he play this kind of role? What was his exact? Pandavanam cha Satyatam. What was the character of the Pandavas? The embodiments of Dharma. Yet, they suffered the most. Possibly. What a... If someone tells me, follow Dharma, you have all success, all happiness, very good. But someone tells me, see the Pandavas, the most Dharma, perfect follows the Dharma, and the worst of situations. Amazing. That's what the Lord does to the best of His. He wants them to play a role in the worst situation. How did they follow Dharma? So then we have no excuse of not following Dharma. No, my situation is too bad. Who can say their situation is worse than the Pandavas? Durvrittam Dhartarashtranam. And the cruelty of the sons of Dhritarashtra and Dhritarashtra himself to the extremes of evil. What did they do and what did they accomplish out of it? Muktavan Bhagavan Rishi, talking about sages in the saints and so many other things. Idam sah, idam shata sahasram tu. Idam shata sahasram tu.
Idam shata sahasram tu.
Lokanam punya karmanam.
Lokanam punya karmanam.
I have thus written shata sahasram. I have written 100,000 verses. Actually, it was not 100,000. It was 100,000, 1 crore. But after he wrote down everything, he found it's too difficult for the human being to digest. So, some 20 lakh he gives to, 40 lakh he gives to the demigods, 20 lakh to the Nagas, 20 lakh to the Gandharvas, telling them, after dividing everything, only 100,000 he says, okay, the human beings can handle this. And Lokanam Punya Karmana. Now he states his purpose very clearly. I want to teach the world how to live a happy life. Su sukham kartum avyayam. The beauty of the Mahabharata teaching us how to be happy in this world and in the next. Not just in this world, not only in the next, but both. If we follow the teachings of Mahabharata, then we learn to be happy both in this world and the next. Upakhyane sahagyayam. Now he's saying upakhyan. Upakhyan means history. Sahagyayam. Adyam bharatam uttamam. And he says anyone who follows this, anyone who read this, Bharatam Uttamam, he now is giving a double meaning. He is saying, this is the highest, this is the best, the greatest epic. We can even see it in the modern times. Which story can one tolerate? How many times can we tolerate the same movie? Once, twice, 10 times, 11 times. How many remakes of how many movies do we have? Okay, there are some record holders here. How many record holders? How many times have you seen? 20 times has anyone seen the same movie? 20? Oh, yeah. 30. No. 30. Oh, between 20 and
30.
Yeah. That's tough.
Yeah.
But the Mahabharata, 5,000 years ago, it was written.